How you doing, and thank you for watching. This is George here, Wicked Warnings, back again with another beautiful truck. This one happens to be a brand new 2020 Ram 2500 Power Wagon. This is the bad boy Ram. It's got locking differentials, front and rear, all kinds of good upgrades on this. I can see it had a winch in the front, but that's been taken out. It is going into work mode. Got a Boss plow on the front of it. Also got a Boss spreader in the rear. You can see on the roof right now, we're featuring our auto flasher module by Wicked Warnings, flashing those factory roof lights. It's a one wire cut install. It's about a 15 minute job to put that flasher on them roof lights. Extremely quick, extremely effective. Around the back, we've got our ThinX strip and a set of our LED HAW duos and the factory cargo light as well. Here you can see another shot of those roof lights. Now, you can install it two different ways. The way you see here, we're flashing all five lights simultaneously by using our Wicked Warnings auto flasher module following the easy to use instructions. You're getting at that wire right in the passenger A-pillar. It's extremely easy. Otherwise, you can lower the middle of the headliner and you could split those roof lights up as well if you'd like to do that. There's a nice side shot for you. This truck was built to spec of the owner. Exactly what he asked for is what he got. Very cool truck. Got some nice aggressive Goodyear Wrangler tires on it. Alrighty, so around the back, as you can see, we are tailgateless through our winter mode. And this does have the all LED tail lights. We haven't messed with those just yet at this time. So what we're featuring is our ThinX strip in an amber white alternating pattern. We got a pair of them synchronized. They're mounted right on the bumper plastic with the VHB tape, and we ran the wiring through a quarter inch hole. Above that, you can see our LED HAW duo. We've got a low dome amber in that factory third brake light by the cargo portions off on the side, and we did relocate the factory bulbs to the inboard side so you didn't lose that door open cargo light. As you can see there, I opened the door, the light is on. Now that cargo light went off automatically. So as you can see, if you have a cargo light like this and a Dodge like this, our LED HAW duo, no problem to retain that factory light as well as add a strobe of all five colors. We've got purple, green, red, blue, amber, and white. So I guess you got a sixth color mixed in. Alrighty, so there's a shot of our ThinX and how we mounted it. We are using the included VHB tape. We did use a primer 94, always a great idea for VHB adhesion. And we also ran a bead of black silicone right along the top edge here, just to help with the salt. Obviously, this is gonna get just covered in salt, and we're gonna try to do our best to get these lights protected, so we did the black silicone across the top. Here you can see how those lights are mounted. Now, we did discuss mounting them there versus mounting them on the actual metal cab, or metal bed right there, just below the Rhino lining, as you can see above the bumper. Both spots work out well. Customer just chose this spot because it brought the light a little farther out and a little closer to the people that are back here by the spreader. So this is where they went. And there's your full-on shot. So you can see there's the brightness of those ThinX strips. Again, that's a ThinX strip, amber white, synchronized, two of them. So as far as switching, what we did here is right here in the cab. We were able to drill down right here. Customer liked this idea. They were totally cool with it for a couple of reasons. One, this panel is cheap and easy to replace. Two, it's right next to his truck and plow headlight switch, so it works out very well. We used a full illumination amber switch because most of the lights are indeed amber. And you do have to notch just a little bit of plastic behind this panel, but you are able to go down here and do yourself a favor, remove this before you drill. It just pops out very easily. This whole panel pops out very easily, and you're able to put that 3/4 inch switch, sorry about the focus, I'm working on that here, there you go. You'll be able to put that 3/4 switch right there. As far as power, we ran right to the battery for this, so he can use these lights anytime he likes. And there's a nice factory area with a plastic cover that you can drill through on these Dodges. No issue going through the firewall at all. Thanks again for watching Wicked Warnings. I hope you liked this video. Be sure to check out the description and links to all the products in this video so you can do this very same job yourself. It's a quick and easy job, and we'll be sure to help you out. Make sure to subscribe and like, share our video. Thanks again, and see you on the next one.